Alright guys, welcome back to another Roblox anime video. Now guys, I was not gonna post this today, but I probably will now because I've gotten some exclusive sneaks on the new update 2 of Anime Defenders. But before we get into it, I do want to say a couple things. I said this in my last video, but if you guys didn't know, I am making my own Roblox anime tower defense game. It's about to be the best game on the entire freaking planet. What the reason I'm telling you guys this right now is because if you join the Discord server right now, there's a chance. Look how many people are joining. We got about like almost 43,000. Well, no. We got 42,000 members in here. But if you come over to Sneak Peeks, you will see that there's this unit inside of here. Now, this is the unit that a lot of people are going to be getting on the release because they came early and they have the early bird role. Now, if you join, you will probably more than likely get the early bird role because we are doing giveaways with it every milestone. So at 40K, 45K, 50K, we're almost at 45K. So you might want to join now so you get a chance to get into this giveaway. We're going to give away it to a couple hundred people, maybe even 1,000. Because right now, I think about 10,000 people have it. So join the Discord server down below. It's going to be the best game ever. Like, let me just show you one more sneak. Like, look at this map. Like, bro, come on now. Like, dog, come on. Come on now. Wait, let me show you one of the VFX. All right, this is one of the VFX. This is Rock Lee. Like, bro, come on. You can't tell me that is not fire over there. You can't tell me that is not fire. But yeah, join the Discord server, Anime Reborn, link is in the description, the first link in the description. Yeah, without further ado, let's get right into it. All right, boys, now you can see me inside the game. So basically, I'm going to be showing you guys all the new exclusive sneaks, and I'm going to be telling you guys the top 10 units that you should have right now if you want to be decent in the new update when it comes around, because I'm sure they're increasing the difficulty levels a lot. But yeah, let's get into it. Let's get into the sneaks first. Tower of Eternity, I think a lot of you guys have seen this, besides you guys that are not in the Discord. But if you're not in the Discord, you should probably join the Discord anyways, and also join Anime Reborn too. But as you can see, Tower of Eternity, what else could this be but Infinity Castle? They just rewarded it. They're kind of maybe Tower of God. I was going to do Tower of God for Anime Reborn. We'll see. But hey, Tower of Eternity, what does this mean? Guys, this basically means that we now have a new gem, grinding method. New gem grinding method. Now, what we will do with this method, I'd recommend to not use any ults at all for any of this stuff, because I'm pretty sure in this update they are nerfing ults a lot. There are some things that I heard, but they could just be speculations. Nobody actually knows. I don't want to say it because everyone will just take it as is. Like, I said that this will happen, but it's not going to happen. Like, we don't know. It's a speculation. But hopefully the devs do something about this, because this just easily promotes everybody to grind with ults. And if everybody's doing it, I don't want to be left out, bro. I'm going to hop in too. But yeah, I would recommend that you prep your ults for this update, just in case. No, I'm just joking. I'm trolling. I'm not promoting ulting at all. But yeah, it is what it is. Hopefully ults don't work actually, because I'm rich right now. I want to stay rich. Like, I don't want inflation to increase and then the gems. Then 200k gems is now seen as like 2,000 gems. That makes any sense, because everybody now will have like 10 million gems each, because everyone's just ulting the Infinity Castle and trading the gems to their main account. But yeah, that is the first sneak. I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys have seen this already, but let's move to the next one. All right guys, moving on to the second sneaks. I actually don't know what it looks like. It's like an icy map. It kind of looks like the one map that the one map the Anime Adventures added for Berserk for Guts. It looks like the Guts map. It looks like the Guts map. The one they added for Guts and their thingy. But let's continue seeing. Oh, this looks clean. The snow and everything. Oh, yeah. Bro, it looks like a Japanese type style map. So this could literally be Demon Slayer. It okay looks like Demon Slayer. It looks like Demon Slayer. It looks like Bleach. It looks like, bro, any anime that uses like super Japanese style art, it looks like. Because look at these houses. Yeah, this looks cool. This looks really cool. So yeah, this map looks awesome. Very awesome. Let me know what you guys think this map is in the comment section down below. Because I honestly don't know, bro. I couldn't really tell you. It low-key looks like Demon Slayer. I don't know. It looks like the Guts / Griffith map for Berserk for Anime Adventures 2. I'm not too sure about that one. But yeah, let me see. Now, moving on to the next sneak is another map sneak. Now, see, I don't actually know what these maps are. I thought it was one thing, and then when I saw the ship, I thought it was something else. Let me play it for you guys. So, boom. Right there, I thought this was like Soul Society or something. Because you see these big walls? The Soul Society low-key looked like this. The Soul Society low-key looked like this. But then as soon as I seen this ship, bro. Wait, who was talking to me in-game, bro? All right, guys. I lied. It was not a model sneak. I don't even know what this is again. I forgot. Start game. Is there showing us some gameplay right now? Infinite Tower. So what does it look like? Okay, so, ooh, that is so cool. I didn't realize at first. But look, right here, there's nothing, and then it breaks and it creates the path. And I think it's randomized every time you play. That is so cool. What? It's like almost randomized every time you play. Or maybe it's not, but I doubt they'll do the exact same animation every time you start it. But look, the track is laid down now. But I feel like, is it randomized every time you play, or is it just the same? Bro, I want to see more. I want to see more. Boom, 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 boom. That is so cool. That is so cool. It looks like the Igris map, the double dungeon. But what is this map anyways? Cursed Dungeon Raid. So is this the Igris map, but it's just light mode? Igris map light mode? Bro, I don't know what that map is. I don't know if you guys know what it means. Maybe something like Tower of God or something. I don't know, bro. If you guys know what this is, let me know in the comment section down below, because yo, a lot of this looks fire. Then of course we got the regular sneak. All right guys, so this is the next sneak. As you guys can see right here, we already seen this one actually, but yeah, he sent it again here. So Tower of Eternity looks hella cool. I don't know where they're gonna squeeze this into the lobby, because if you go to the lobby right now, they put it right here. So they put the thing right here. So then, like, isn't there gonna, like, there's not gonna be space for this now. Like, how is that gonna work? And guys, this is the next sneak. This is what makes me think that it is Bleach. Because if we look right here, these look like Bleach katanas. And then this character in particular looks like a Bleach character I think you guys all know. Tell me the resemblance is not there, guys. So this is Toshiro right here from Bleach, Soul Society. And then this is the sneak right here. This is the sneak right here. Tell me that is not supposed to be Toshiro right here. Toshiro doesn't have glasses though, I'm not gonna lie. But maybe I'm completely wrong. Maybe I'm completely wrong and it's from like some new gen manhwa or manga or even some anime ongoing right now that I have nothing about. I know nothing about, but hey, that sure does look like Toshiro. All right, boys, I was literally about to end the video right there. As you can see, I'm making my thumbnail right now. But they show us new sneaks, and they show us a lot more stuff. Let me go through it again. Let me go actually go through it right now. So the first new sneak they showed us is this train station. Now, because I saw this portal, I instantly already thought that it was Solo Leveling. But hold your horses. What other game has a train station? No, sorry, not a game. What other anime has a train station that was just in the most recent season? Yeah, you guessed it right. Jujutsu Kaisen. To be fair, this is probably Solo Leveling, I'm not gonna lie. Because I see the crystals and stuff. This map in particular is Solo Leveling, but they... Actually, I don't know if it is or not. I'm very confused. I don't know. It's either Jujutsu Kaisen or Solo Leveling. Maybe they're trying to make it look different. It is Solo Leveling. As you can see, this mirror thingy right here. It is Solo Leveling. But the reason I was mentioning the train station and Shibuya and Gojo is because the next sneak, which is showing us some abilities right here. This is obviously Tanjiro's ability. You can see that the Demon Slayer art style thingy. It looks like Tanjiro anyways. We got this as well, which it looks like Tanjiro art style, like Demon Slayer art style. So maybe this is a Demon Slayer map, who knows? Yeah, this is the map I showed you guys earlier, the one that looks like Soul Society. This water move looks like Tanjiro, that's what I'm gonna say. We got hollow purple. Wait, that's a purple ball and a blue ball, the frick? Purple and blue does not equal. I can see someone's white. Wait, hold on. Let me increase this. I can see someone's head there. They're trying to keep it a mystery as much as possible, but I can see a white head there. That has to be Gojo, bro. This has to be Gojo. So it's not hollow purple. It's now purple and blue. What does purple and blue make? Green or something? I don't even know, bro. But yeah, I guess this is how this is looking. We got hollow purple or something like that. But yeah, we got Gojo inside of the new update too, which is crazy in my opinion. Then obviously we got the lion ability. So yeah, it is hollow purple, as you can see from this. This is hollow purple 100%. Look at this. Oh my god. Hollow purple 100%. Look at the line AoE. Yeah, hollow purple. And this is the explosion. I'm seeing 1,345 damage. So is that him on placement? Does he have hollow purple on placement? Is the stats not done yet? I'm not sure. We got 1,345 damage. So maybe that's there too. Then we have another water wheel attack here. 336 damage. So... is Tanjiro not a mythic, or is this him at level 1, non-evolved? I don't know. But yeah, guys, that is currently all the sneaks for the new update that they've shown us. Now, the only thing I would say you guys should do right now to prepare for this new update is grind out star fruits, grind out gems, grind out rerolls, grind as much as possible of everything that's ultable, and I would say to trade it to your main account, because in this upcoming update, I am very sure that they are nerfing ults. They might even make it so that you can't even trade some of the storage that you have on your ults into your main account. So I would just put everything on your main account now and then see what happens during the update, and then trade it back if everything's good. Because I feel like they're going to like do it. Because they can't just add Infinity Castle and not nerf ults. Because then that just means the economy is going to go absolutely crazy. Because everyone's going to be able to get like 2 million gems each for the Infinity Castle. If it is similar to AA. Now moving on to the next part of this video. Is the top units that you need to get for update 2. Now, things though, I don't even have one of these units that I'm about to tell you guys. But yeah, let's get right into that. Oh, speaking of the devil. So the first unit you guys are going to want to get for update 2 is Sharpshooter. Now, a lot of you guys know Sharpshooter is probably not that strong on its own. But she is the only air mythical unit inside of the game. And as we know right now, there are no air units inside of Anime Defenders. So I believe that there will be air units, air mobs in the new update. Maybe. If it isn't, then oh well. I mean, there's going to be new air units in the update, so if you want to be ahead of everybody and not having to summon for the new air units they'll add, possibly. I don't know if there's going to be air units. I'm only speculating, okay? Nothing I say is definite. So I would say get Sharpshooter. I'm actually going to get her right now. Let me just not even waste time. Let me just buy this potion. I better get it, like, instantly. Alright, let's go, baby. Let's go. I better get it like instantly, bro. Give me Sharpshooter. Hope I get a shiny one too. Oh my goodness. How long is this gonna take? Oh, actually, I've never gotten Sung Ju from the banner. That's why I've realized now. This might take longer than I thought. And then I forgot to stretch my feet. Come on, bro. Oh my goodness. Bro, come on. Chat, please. Come on. Bro, I feel like I'm going to have to reach pity for this. Okay, I need to stretch my feet and come back. All right. Bit of a stretch. Let's go. Come on. Bro, I'm trying to do a video. Just give me this mythic. I didn't know this was this hard to get when you're actually trying to get a mythic and not a secret. Like, bro. Come on, man. There we go, finally. Okay. If this is a shiny, I'm going to shout. Because I've never gotten a shiny before. Of course it isn't a shiny. Holy crap, her stats are so bad. Let me go spin that real quick. Yeah, so you basically want to get this unit right here. Sharpshooter. Where is she? Sharpshooter. There we go. I'm gonna reroll it quickly. What the hell? Okay, go again. No. Oh my god. Okay. I'm actually gonna use the Sharpshooter for the new update. I'm gonna evolve her. I'll probably do a video tomorrow evolving her. Okay, now you wanna bring her? She's definitely one of the units that you're gonna need for the new update, so let me equip her real quick. Sharpshooter. I would probably trade on my units to use the food items. Sharpshooter. And then you guys are also going to want to grind star fruits. So I'm going to play that right now. I have enough rainbows. I don't think I necessarily need to play that one. I do have enough rainbows. I'll play this one because I need the other stars. She is an air unit. I don't know why these maps have no air unit slots. Like, what the flip? Wait, this is an air unit slot? Feels like the ground. I'm not going to lie. But hey, this is actually a good spot. This is actually a pretty good slot. So, boom. Basically, she's an air unit. And, yeah, she triple attacks. She's weak. She's super weak right now because she's level 1 and she has an F stat. But, yeah. She hits for 3 tick, and I'm pretty sure she stuns at max level. Let me try to get a second move. She's just overall, like, all in all, like, a very good unit. So, that is number 1 unit I recommend you guys get or you need to get right now. Now, number 2 unit is going to be Igris Almighty. If you don't have Igris Almighty, I recommend you guys just go grind for it and just get Igris Almighty, because normal Igris is not enough. I'm trolling. I know not everybody can just get Igris Almighty or Almighty Igris, so Igris is enough. So if you have like some shinies that you know you don't care about cosmetics, sell it for gems and go summon for Igris, because he is gone next update and he's so OP for a unit that is exclusive. I don't know why they would even do this, but yeah. He's super overpowered. Let me place him down real quick. My one is insanely overpowered because he's almighty. But even if he's not almighty, he's still super overpowered. And he basically inflicts the same stat the same. He basically flicks the same status effect as Yuji Itadori, the legendary one. He makes him take more damage, and he's super. He's full AoE and he has insane damage. Like, bro, insane damage, insane. So yeah, he's definitely number two. Definitely get bro right here. He's insane. Now number three is definitely not Ichigo. He was for last update. He's out of meta now. He's too weak. Unless you're a brand new player, I wouldn't even recommend getting this guy. I'm not gonna lie. Don't get him at all. But a unit that I do recommend you guys get is Katakuri. My one has Almighty on him. I don't know how I managed to pull this. My one is shiny too. You don't need Almighty. All you need is a Sonic 3. Sorry, I said Sonic 3. All you need is Sonic 1 or Haste. Not Haste. What's it called? Runner 3. Is that what it was called? Runner 3 or one that... So you need to increase the range or increase the SPA. Or if you have both the traits on the one, is I guess that's cool. But yeah, that's pretty much it. He's number three. You need to get... Basically, why you need to get him because he slows. I would actually probably take Grave, but also I need to deal damage now, so I will probably take Donut Warrior. I'll get him to second upgrade too, to the point where he shoots donut bullets because that's his fastest SPA. That is honestly his fastest SPA, and he... Oh, never mind. It's not as fast as... This is his fastest AoE. But this is the best move he has right here. This is the best move that he has right here. So I would recommend getting this guy too. Well, let me just get this move real quick. Boom. The move. He basically shoots like bullets. Yeah, he slows them, which is kind of nice. He slows them for the whole duration of that move, plus extra. So yeah, he's a pretty good character. Yep. So he's definitely the next one. And then obviously the next ones I would recommend is obviously the no-brainer. Get Bocchi, get her with Midas Touch. And get Bulma, Midas Touch, obviously. It's self-explanatory. It's really self-explanatory. All right, we just completed the stage. So this is something that's recommend. Grind these star fruits out. Do with your ults, whatever. Just grind a lot of these fruits because they might nerf it. I'm very sure they will nerf it. Ooh, that's actually a pretty good trait. Bullseye 1 and Hunter 1. That is actually pretty darn good. Because Bullseye already increases my thingy. Wait, why is this glitched? Okay, this thing is bugging. Okay, whatever. Alright, that's bugging. Basically, that increases my range a lot. I'm actually going to keep that. So yeah, the next unit you guys are going to want to get is both Garp and Chehei, whatever her name is. And this is the reason why. So first one is obviously Chehei-in, or whatever her name is. Only because she is now probably the new strongest unit with the lowest SPA that is full AoE. But her range actually is not that big, I'm not going to lie. But she's still pretty strong. So you need to get her. She's absolutely strong. Plus, she's a limited unit, so yeah. So next to Igris would probably be either her or Garp. I'm not going to lie. I think Garp might be slightly better. But her SPA is lower and she's full AoE too. But yeah, Ash has Bullseye on her. She has Bullseye, and this is how big her range is. And this is Ichigo's range on placement. It's almost as big. But anyways, yeah. Wait, why am I bugging? So when we upgrade her, she gets a full AoE with a pretty decent, pretty strong range, low SPA. So she's definitely going to be a must. And then the next one is also Garp 2. Although he's super slow, I think he deals more damage than her. I'm not going to lie. And also, he gives full AoE. So he's also pretty darn strong. So yeah, there's that too. So these are the two units you're going to want to definitely get before the new update. And then you control Furin if you really need her. Honestly, I don't know. I always thought Furin is better than Garp, but you guys said it's not. So it is what it is, okay? But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this quick video. I'm going to see you guys in the stream tomorrow. I have no videos for tomorrow, so I'll see you guys in the stream then. I hope you enjoyed the video, and yeah, peace out.